Designed experiments are found here under the Quick DOE link in the Improve phase, and when you click on that, you'll get a page that looks like this. You'll find a number of different designed experiments that you can do, but just as we were doing in part one, we're going to focus on a 2 to the k factorial experiment, and more specifically, we're going to focus on full factorial designs where all possible combinations of input variables are done. So the one that we looked at before was a 3-factor, 8-run. And in this context, these 8 runs form what's called a replicate, one kind of natural complete set of data. So all I have to do is click Generate Design and OK. And let me pop this up where you can see it a little better. And you may notice that we've got exactly the same balanced design that we had in the simulator. Low high, alternating, and then 2 lows and 2 highs, and then 4 lows and 4 highs. And a place over here that we can record our output variable when we put these inputs into that state. Now, normally we will run with more than one replicate. And to decide how many replicates we need, we come over here and we enter the smallest effect that we think will be of interest to us. And the standard deviation of the process when it's not being disturbed, normally we'll just leave alpha at 0.05. And we see that our power is pretty low. Small probability of catching an event if it happens. But as I increase replicates, my power meter comes up. And when I get to, let's try 4 replicates. Now I've got pretty good power, 92% probability of catching the effect if it happens. Normally, you will want to put the names of the variables in here. And so let's just call this one time, and let's give it the same values that we saw in the simulator. 296 here for a low, and 304 for a high. And let's give this let's call this one pressure, and give that the same values that we saw, which were, if I remember correctly, 50 and 110. And C, I'm going to call, catalyst. Maybe this is some kind of a chemical process. And I'm going to enter the same numbers that we had before, 1.7 and 2.3. Now let's see what we get. We should get 4 times 8 is 32 data occurring in natural blocks of 8. So let's click our Generate Design and see what we get. OK, and expand, and sure enough, I've got 32, and if you look, this pattern repeats. 1 through 8 are the first replicate, 9 through 16 are the second, and so on down. And this is exactly what we generated in our simulator. Now, if I want to randomize my experiment, and that's very good practice, then I just go to Run Order and click Sort and Ascending, and now it's randomized. And if I want to put it back, I just sort on Design Order, and it will put it back the way it was. So, pretty simple to get that set up, and then we'll go on to Phase 3 and teach you how to do and interpret an experiment.